Hi, I'm Kara. I'm one of the CVTs here at DoveLewis. This is one of our TAs, Allison, and this is Simon. And today we're going to talk to you about how to stop a nail when it's bleeding. This can happen for many reasons. Most of the time when owners are doing it at home, they're trying to give a nail trim. But oftentimes we see some sort of trauma event when they come in. Either they tore a dew claw when they were playing, they got into some sort of altercation with a housemate, things like that. So these can present in all sorts of different ways. Typically when we see a nail trimmer incident, it's usually just the tip of the nail that was quicked. The nails actually have a blood supply as well as a nerve that run through and stop at a certain point. So if you trim too far, you can actually hit that blood vessel and that nerve. It'll cause some very minor bleeding, but it can be pretty alarming to owners. It's pretty insignificant. They're not going to bleed out through their nail, but it looks like a lot because it is in a really inconvenient space. They're walking on it. They're continuing to disrupt that clot, which just keeps bleeding and bleeding, or they're licking at it and disrupting the clot, and that can be frustrating for owners as well. But if we do happen to do this in clinic, or we can instruct owners at home on how to remedy this, if I'm doing a nail trim and I do happen to quick a dog, we have styptic powder or quick stop in hospital. So we actually will just apply, it's a fine powder, and we'll just apply a very little bit to the affected nail in an even layer and kind of apply some pressure. And that's gonna create a seal on that nail, and that's gonna help form that clot and stop the bleeding. If owners don't have this at home, that's okay. They can use something like flour or cornstarch in the same manner, and that will do the same exact thing that the styptic powder does. But owners can also get this online or at most pet stores as well. So it is something that's very readily available. If they don't have any of those things, they can also just apply firm pressure. We can do that in hospital as well with a clean towel or gauze. So I would just take some square gauze and hold pressure to it until it stops bleeding. Once that clot is there, they should be okay, as long as they're not continuing to lick at it. If they do continue to lick, they might need to have a cone or something on for a short period of time until it's not so agitating to them. So if he's actually torn his nail, that's going to require a little bit different treatment, and will be based off of how significant the nail has been torn. So oftentimes with longer nails, sometimes they just split up the middle and there'll be two sections, and we can just trim that sort of flyaway section off with nail trimmers and then treat the nail as if we had quicked him. So with the quick stop and just some clean pressure, and that should be enough. If he's actually torn his nail off or down to his actual pad, that's going to be a different story as well, depending on how severe it is. So if he's broken his nail completely off, but there's still a portion right up against his toe, we will do a little bit more of a wound clean. So we'll actually take clippers, we'll trim away the hair around the nail, especially if he's longer haired, because now we actually have an open wound and we want to get rid of all of that hair that'll just hold on to blood and bacteria and may cause an infection. And then we're going to use some chlorhexidine and actually clean that area really well and flush it with saline to remove any of the dirt, debris, and make sure that that wound is actually nice and clean. He will most likely have to wear a cone because they usually tend to lick at it because that's more of an agitating wound on their foot, but it should heal up pretty nicely in a few days. If the nail is completely ripped out, we usually recommend just having a doctor peek at that to see if it requires any sort of stitching or more significant wound clean, but most of the time that doesn't happen. But again, it's just based off of severity of the nail injury. We see these often with the dew claws, these sort of dangly nails that are higher up. A lot of breeds have multiple ones, like Great Pyrenees, that are excessively long and dangly. And for our rowdier patients, when they are playing outside, they'll snag and sometimes they'll rip clean off, and that may actually require some stitching and a sedated sort of wound repair. Now, when dealing with any of these, whether it's just a basic sort of quick stop, I quicked a nail, or the more significant wounds, I do want to make sure that my patient is comfortable and I have appropriate restraint. So I'm not doing solo nail trims in the hospital, especially with patients that I'm unfamiliar with. A lot of dogs do not enjoy having their feet touched, and that can be a source of agitation for them, and they might try to nip or bite. I also want to make sure that I can focus on what I'm doing and not have to focus on him and whether or not both of us are safe and comfortable. So I always trim with a restrainer. I need some time to sort of get that on there and hold pressure so it's much more comfortable and safe when I have a restrainer as well. And definitely if we have a more significant injury, like a fully torn nail or a removed nail, that's pretty painful. So sometimes some local blocks are used, some pain medication, but definitely safe restraint. So I would never attempt this without someone assisting me because that's pretty painful and I just want to make sure that we're all nice and safe and comfortable. But these are just the basics on how to stop a bleeding broken nail. Thanks.